I think a lot of people in the audience, a lot of people listening to this podcast have at some point met a girl online or met a guy online. You've met somebody you were talking to online. You became friends with them online, Instagram or Tinder or Bumble or Facebook, whatever. You met someone online and you talked to them. You became friends with them. And it's even more so ramped up if it's a person you like, you're interested in physically or interested in, maybe you'll date them. When you meet someone you date, you might want to date that you met online. When you go from online to meeting them in person the very first time, you are very careful with your expectations. Because the truth is, you don't really know until you see them. And you know, you could hear, you think they're awesome, you think they're beautiful, yada yada, in pictures. But until you see them in real life, you don't actually know what's going to happen. That, I think, is a very similar situation to Richard Sherman this year with the San Francisco 49ers. Niners Nation is a fantastic website. It's a great website. They are great. And they just wrote about how they are setting their expectations for Richard Sherman in 2018. In fact, Niners Nation, I can't tell anyone else does this. Maybe they do, maybe they don't. I think Niners Nation started this. They started calling Richard Sherman Uncle Sherm. I love that. It's fantastic. I'm going to embrace it. I'll give them credit. But I'm going to start calling him Uncle Sherm because I think that's fantastic. And I want to tell you my guy's expectations for this. These are my expectations for Uncle Sherm. And I very much tempered my expectations. Again, very similar to meeting a person that I've met online for the first time in real life. We matched on Tinder. We've talked for 2 weeks. Now I'm going to meet them in person. My expectations are very low because I want to protect my heart. And there are reasons that my expectations for Richard Sherman are very low. First of all, he's 30 years old. And he's coming off one of his worst years in a long time. And he's also coming off an Achilles injury. An injury that very few people, I don't know that really anybody's recovered from very well. I'm sure it happens. But I know a lot of people that have hurt their Achilles in real life, my friends, and they didn't recover. Like they were not good later. And so I have significantly lowered expectations about Richard Sherman's success as a 49er. I mean, I think Richard Sherman is a great leader. I think he's going to coach up guys really well. And I do think he also significantly helped with the Reuben Foster situation. But I do not expect Richard Sherman to be a Pro Bowler. Maybe Richard Sherman has a Pro Bowl performance this season. That would be fantastic. That would be awesome. I would love that. But if Richard Sherman is a Pro Bowler this year, I think 49ers fans should be pleasantly surprised. I would not expect that. And I would recommend that you protect your heart. If you're a 49er fan, don't expect so much from Richard Sherman and protect your heart. Because if you expect him to be great, you're setting yourself up to get hurt. Similarly to meeting someone that you met on Tinder in real life and going, they're going to be the best person ever, yada, yada. And you meet them and it's deflating because they're not what you expect, not exactly what you hope for. Richard Sherman is the same way. Let's wait and see. And I hope he's great. Let's hope for the best. If you're a 49er fan, I'm actually not really a 49er fan, but I'm going to follow them very closely this year. But if you are a 49ers fan and you want good from Richard Sherman, that's great. But don't expect it. Hope for it. You can hope for it. But I think if you expect it, you're going to be let down. It's very possible. So I would temper your expectations with Richard Sherman according to the fact that he's 30, he's coming off an injury, and he's coming off one of his worst years of his career. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Remember, if you want to help Strong Opinion Sports grow, you can share this with your friends on Facebook, on Twitter, on Instagram, whatever it is. Help me grow Strong Opinion Sports by telling your friends about this show. And always remember, you can subscribe to Strong Opinion Sports on iTunes, on SoundCloud, everywhere you can find a podcast, as well as YouTube. My full entire podcast is on YouTube, as well as shorter, more interesting clips like this. So thank you so much. Have a great day, and take care.